We are moving quickly to bring audiences the first television series based on one of the greatest science fiction horror classics ever made.
What?
Alien.
What?
FX's Alien will be helmed by Fargo and Legion's Noah Hawley, stepping into the creator, executive producer chair, working alongside Sir Ridley Scott.
What?
Set not too far into our future, it's the first Alien story set on Earth. And by blending both the timeless horror of the first Alien film with the nonstop action of the second, it's going to be a scary thrill ride that will blow people back in their seats.
Non ha senso. Non ha senso. Eh no, non me lo fanno vedere questo. Oh no. Ma chi se ne frega? Annunciano una serie di Alien? Ambientata, a parte che non è vero che è la prima storia di Alien ambientata sulla Terra, perché nessuno ha visto Alien vs Predator. E sì, dobbiamo considerarli Alien, non mi frega niente di quello che dice Ridley Scott. Poi, che Alien vs Predator 2 facesse schifo, ok, però il primo è super carino.
Today we're happy to announce several new projects in development and production.
Okay.
This is where nostalgia meets the future. We begin with Disney Animation's first ever animated series. It takes place in one of our favorite fantastical cities and stars one of our most
uno dei peggiori film da Disney mai fatto.
To tell you more is the Oscar-winning director of Big Hero
Oscar Win Oscar che hanno rubato dei Lego Movie che erano usciti nello stesso anno.
Hey everybody, I'm Don Hall, director of Big Hero 6.
Sì,
I'm so
idiota.
Excited to talk to you about Baymax, the series for Disney Plus.
Ho detto che odio questo film visceralmente. Magari la serie è bella, in realtà. Perché il vero problema.
The series really focuses on Baymax's original protocol, which is to
oh,
be a nurse robot.
Per esempio.
In this episode, we meet a new character,
sì, cioè,
a patient that Baymax is going to help. I would like to be more like Baymax. His kindness, his compassion, his single-minded devotion to
beh,
just helping.
Forse stanno trasformando.
He's kind of a hero for the times.
Questo. And lastly, il concept, stanno salvando il concept con questa serie.
That will allow him to quickly travel around the streets of San Francisco looking for patients. Thank you everybody. We're very excited to show you more.
Cioè, nel senso.
Baymax will be
oh
on
no,
Disney Plus in early
devo curare le persone, trasformiamolo in un robot assassino.
Also in production. Welcome back.
Odio quel film. E poi serve a promuovere la l'acquisto della Disney della Marvel. Lasciamo stare.
A short form series called Zootopia Plus. Zootopia Plus takes a hilarious look at some of the animals we only briefly met in the Oscar-winning film,
okay,
including Fru Fru, gazelles, tiger dancers, and our favorite sloth, Flash.
We'll
get insight into their lives through the lens of Zootopia's hottest shows, like The Real Mousewives of Little Rodentia, So You Think You Can Prance, and a show that follows the fast lane of life at sloth speed.
Questi sono tre corti, no?
Disney Plus. In spring 2022.
Sarà una serie, saranno dei corti così.
Cinderella.
What?
Ariel.
Sì?
Elsa.
Oh no.
Jasmine.
Oh no.
Rapunzel.
Lo fanno.
Disney Animation has brought
breaks
the
internet
to the screen. Characters that people connect with and who stand the test of time. And with Disney Plus we're creating new stories for these characters, starting with a favorite from New Orleans, Princess Tiana.
Oh, l'unico film Disney che non ho visto praticamente.
Tiana and her friends back for all new stories in a long form musical comedy series. The possibilities are endless, with Tiana stepping into a role as a princess of a land we have yet to visit, and with so much more of New Orleans yet to see.
E mi interessa un sacco perché è animazione
Tiana
2D, io adoro animazione 2D.
In 2023.
Quindi ottimo, fanno nuova animazione 2D.
There is another
credo
series we're excited to announce. One that focuses on a heroine who asks herself how far she'll
oh no
go. Yes, we are developing a
oh
long form
no
musical comedy series exploring new stories with Moana. There is such a deep love for this character in this film, and that love has only grown in the years since the film's initial release. In the series, Moana's boundless sense of adventure and skills at wayfinding take her far beyond the reef. Since our first research trips to the region for the film, we continue to be inspired by the deep oral storytelling traditions of the Pacific Islands.
Sì, ma
and to help
c'è
tell
Maui
the stories for this new series, we are connecting with talent from the region. Moana the series will be on Disney Plus in 2023.
Cioè, è National Geographic fatto con la tizia di
there
Moana
is one more series I am thrilled to announce today. An all-new, all-original series created in a whole new way for our studio. Back in the beginning of 2019, I saw a news piece about a group of storytellers and artists from Nigeria and Uganda. The title of this video was Pan-African Comic Book Hopes to Kick Disney's You Know What. I was intrigued. Here were three talented comic book artists. Tolu Olofoyeku, Zeke Nelson, and Hamid Ibrahim founded an entertainment company called Hugali. Their dream was to bring African stories created by African artists to the world through comics and animation, highlighting the diversity of cultures, history, and voices across the continent. Their talents as storytellers blew us away. Mm-hmm. I'm proud to announce a first-of-its-kind collaboration as Hugali and Disney Animation team up to bring their original long-form series to Disney+. The series is called Iwaju, which in the Yoruba language roughly translates to the future. Set in Lagos, Nigeria, and steeped in science fiction, Iwaju explores deep themes of class, innocence, and challenging the status quo. Iwaju will debut on Disney Plus in 2022. As you can see, we're embracing the opportunities Disney Plus provides.
Allora, we cannot sappiamo perché fanno una serie del genere. Ciononostante, ha un potenziale.
I want to leave you with a very special project. Our animated feature film set to release fall of 2021. We've not officially announced this movie until today.
Okay.
For our 60th feature, magical realism sets the stage, and yes, it is a musical stage, as we travel to Colombia, where a magical family, the Madrigals, live in an equally magical home. Our film is called Encanto. Why? Because an Encanto is a charmed place, born of its unique wonders, where life itself is wondrous. Directors Byron Howard and Jared Bush, the filmmaking team that brought you the Academy Award-winning Zootopia, are joined by co-director and co-writer Charisse Castro-Smith, and bringing his talents as both songwriter and story collaborator is the incomparable Lin-Manuel Miranda. It's hard to believe it's been 4 years since we first heard his incredible music in Moana, and we are so excited to re-team with him for Encanto.
Okay. Allora, mentre fanno vedere questa cosa agli altri, volevo soltanto dirvi, non ho registrato le mie reaction perché non mi fregava niente, ma ve lo dico tanto per... Hanno annunciato tipo le nuove live action. Faranno il live action. Signori, attenzione a quello che sto per dire. Faranno il live action del Re Leone. Voi direte, l'hanno già fatto? Cacchio mi dici? No, 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 no. C'è un piccolo particolare. È un prequel. Cioè faranno un prequel al Re Leone utilizzando il live action.
From Kumandra to Colombia, San Francisco to Zootopia, from New Orleans to the Pacific Islands.
Vabbè, avevano annunciato la Sirenetta di colore, Peter Pan, dove c'è cavolo si chiama Jude Law che fa Capitano Uncino.
Introduce my esteemed colleague at our fellow animation studio, a person both tall in stature and in talent, from Pixar Animation Studios, Chief Creative Officer Pete Docter.
Ok, passiamo alla Pixar che, per favore, anche se la Disney vi sta rovinando, qualcosa potete fare? Please.
Hey everybody, I'm Pete Docter. Pixar started in 1986 with the dream to take the wonderful tradition of animation and transform it using state-of-the-art computer technology. Tradition and innovation, two opposing concepts, have been at the heart of Pixar since the very beginning. Since then, we've gone on to make 23 feature films and many, many shorts. And as a director of several of these films, it makes me so happy to hear that folks who grew up on these films as kids are now passing them along to kids of their own. It's hard to believe Pixar has been around 34 years, but you know what? Truth is, we're just getting started. Today, I'm excited to introduce you to a bunch of fresh new filmmakers. Getting their voices on the screen is our key focus right now, while at the same time allowing our veteran filmmakers to continue to mature and do their great work. And I think that's really what we do best at Pixar. We honor tradition while at the same time innovating for the future.
Innovating.
Here's something that sure took a lot of innovation. It's our 23rd feature film, called Soul.
Sono molto curioso,
and it's one of the most challenging and rewarding projects I've ever directed, that's for sure. Soul is set in two distinct places, one that's familiar and one you've never seen before.
E dovrebbe uscire
into what makes us who we are,
senza pagare
and
extra.
What we do with our limited time here on Earth, appreciating the simple joys of life, finding the spark that makes you you. The themes of Soul feel so timely to us right now that we're happy that this movie will be shared this year with audiences around the world. We're excited to bring a little joy to everybody this holiday season.
Joy.
So let's take a look at what you'll see this Christmas on Disney Plus.
Fate sempre piangere con qualsiasi cosa. Io sono che ha suonato, come sapete, io sono molto legato alla musica, ho suonato clarinetto per anni, ormai per un decennio. Quindi se c'è uno che si commuove con la musica di questo genere sono io.
That's a good thing. Look, I remember one time my dad took me to this jazz club, and that's the last place I wanted to be. But then I see this guy, and he's playing these chords with force on it. And then with a minor, I'm like, whoa, whoa, whoa. Then he has the inner voices, and it's like he's singing. And I swear, the next thing I know, it's like he floats off the stage. That guy was lost in the music. He was in it, and he took the rest of us with him. That's when I knew I was born to play.
Io ve l'ho mai detto che ho avuto la fortuna di assistere a un concerto del gruppo jazz di Woody Allen. Sì. Ho visto Woody Allen in persona suonare il clarinetto. perché la sua band era passata a Milano. Non vedrò mai Harrison Ford. Non vedrò mai Mark Hamill. Non vedrò mai Carrie Fisher per ovvie ragioni. Però almeno.
Speaking of Disney Plus, we have a bunch of new projects
sentito Woody Allen suonare
exclusively for the streaming service. Now hopefully you've been able to check out some of our Spark shorts.
Sì, li ho visti.
These are a collection of shorts made
Pur
by
bello, Kit Pur è bello.
New storytellers
out, ok.
They've really struck a chord with many
tutti gli altri sono da buttare.
Our next Spark short,
Barron non l'ho visto infatti.
Follows a young rapper
non c'era.
She tries to build the home of her dreams. It's by first-time director Maddie Sharafian, and I'm excited to say it's going to be released on Disney Plus along with Soul this Christmas. We've also launched a new documentary series called Inside Pixar, which invites you into our studio for an up-close, never-before-seen look at the artistry, the craftsmanship, and the storytelling of Pixar.
Il documentario su Frozen 2
on Disney Plus, so check them out. And more are scheduled to be
released in the
coming months.
Quanto sono incapaci quelli della Disney.
Next,
adoro quel documentario.
With Pixar Popcorn. This collection of mini shorts feature your favorite Pixar characters in all new bite-sized stories created by Pixar animators.
What?
These were a blast to make. Pixar Popcorn comes to Disney Plus this coming January.
Altro materiale degli incredibili.
We also have three all new series that you'll soon be seeing on Disney Plus. The first is near to my heart as it's a spin-off from Up called Doug Days. It's written and directed
Doug
by
Days.
The hilarious
Woo.
Bob Peterson, the creator of Forky Asks a Question and the voice of Doug. This brand new series follows our favorite talking dog, now with Carl, as he returns from the dangers of the South American jungles to the dangers of suburbia.
Con serie, di solito, intendono robe da tre minuti.
Puppies, fireworks, and of course, squirrel! Doug Days will premiere
quindi, okay.
On Disney Plus
cioè,
in the fall
bene.
Of 2021.
Here's a volte...
from one of our favorite episodes.
Okay, perché io temo a volte che dicono che serie sono enormi, invece no, sono tipo corti da tre minuti.
You might want to quiet it down.
I want the puppies to wake up so that I may take care of the puppies.
You got your wish.
Puppies.
Okay, here they come.
Tipo quello di Forky chiede domande alla fine ce n'è qualcuno molto simpatico. Cioè Forky fa domande, non mi ricordo come si chiama in italiano.
Have fun, Doug!
I I am faster than you. I am faster than a puppy. Hello, puppies. It is me, Doug. Oh, puppies.
Sì, ma quando arriva il dramma, quando è che se ne mangia uno per sbaglio? Ops, ho invocato il mangiare.
Now I am turning. Ow, turning and hurting. It is kind of fun. Ah, fun and hurting.
Bang, bang, bang.
Next, we are excited to reignite the Cars franchise with an all-new series that follows Lightning McQueen and his best friend Mater as they head on a road trip across the country. These episodes will be filled with lots of fun new characters, imaginative destinations, as well as old friends checking in along the way. Our all-new Cars series is coming to Disney Plus in the fall of 2022. Following that, we're very excited to announce Pixar's first ever original long-form animated series. This is a big deal for us.
Infatti.
It's being written and directed by two young story artists, Kerry Hobson and Michael Yates. While working together on Toy Story 4, these two often noticed that they'd have very different impressions of the very same meeting. One would think it went great, the other thought it was a disaster. And they thought, hey, that would be a cool thing to explore. And it developed into an original series we're calling Win or Lose. This series follows a co-ed middle school softball team in the week leading up to their championship game. Each 20-minute episode follows the same week, but from the perspective of a different character. But it's not really so much about softball as it is a comedy about love, rivalry, and the challenges we all face in our struggle to win at life. Win or Lose is coming exclusively to Disney Plus in the fall of 2023.
Ok, dai, idee nuove, sempre da promuovere.
Those are the projects we're working on for Disney Plus, all being made by our filmmakers in Emeryville with the same passion and excitement and quality as our feature films. And speaking of our feature films, we have an exciting lineup to share with you that really captures that perfect blend of tradition and innovation that I talked about earlier.
Ci parlano del film fatto dall'italiano.
The center of each of our big tentpole films
ambientato
is a deeply personal story.
Nella mia città natale.
No exception.
Oh yes.
Luca is the first feature for director Enrico Casarosa, who made the short film
La Luna. Esatto.
And it's a love letter to Enrico's home country of Italy. And a celebration of the universal themes of friendship.
Sì, ma Italy dove?
In a beautiful seaside town on the Italian Riviera, this original film is a heartfelt story about a young boy named Luca and his best friend Alberto, who experience an unforgettable summer filled with gelato, pasta, and endless scooter rides. Luca dives into theaters around the world.
Da quello che ho capito dovrebbero essere praticamente le Cinque Terre, Genova, che è la mia città. E ovviamente non ce lo fanno vedere. Non ci fanno vedere la mia città. Anzi, dovrei dire qualcosa tipo Oh Belange, ti besughi. Manco due palanche di troppo, e due sti qua non fanno vedere due cose. Però potevamo farmelo vedere, cioè, la città ce l'avesse sempre così. Sono della loro terra, potevano farmelo vedere. Un pochino della mia città, potevano farmelo vedere. Adesso sembravo Mike Buongiorno. 7. 7. Bingo. Ma credete che io non conosca Michael Giacchino? Questo fior. Ok. Mamma mia. La Luna, fatto dall'italiano. L'italiano stesso. Promosso a fare un intero film Pixar ambientato in Italia. L'italiano che fa un film ambientato in Italia, Pixar. Vi rendete conto dell'originalità di questa frase? Per di più, le immagini mi ricordano la mia terra, quindi. Salve, sono il Così dal Futuro che interrompe. Vorrei farvi mostrare, cioè vorrei dare una piccola osservazione di come siamo fatti noi umani, perché rivedendo il video ci ho pensato, non dico molto, ma mi sono detto wow, perché qui abbiamo il prodotto italiano fatto dall'italiano che racconta appunto la mia terra natia come la sua, e quindi c'è questo lavoro prodotto di amore, e dove si vuole appunto rappresentare qualcosa di assolutamente personale. E avete sentito come ho appena reagito. Allo stesso tempo c'è stata anche prima un annuncio del genere, no? C'è stato anche prima un annuncio del genere, ovvero quel prodotto fatto da quei tre fumettisti che hanno tentato di sfidare la Disney, appunto, e che sono stati assunti dalla Disney stessa per appunto sviluppare questa serie loro. E però lì ho reagito, diciamo, con un'ottica più politica, ma perché appunto la Disney ha persino creato una categoria su Disney Plus che si chiama tipo storie degli uomini di colore, una cosa del genere, adesso non voglio fare disinformazione, non mi ricordo il nome esatto, andate a controllare. Però sì, che si voglia dire o meno, anche se non voglio puntare il dito contro niente e nessuno, secondo me, mera opinione personale, quindi per favore davvero prendete tutto quello che dico con le pinze, perché qua uno dice una cosa e ovviamente viene assolutamente frainteso ogni volta che si dice qualcosa, ma secondo me creare una categoria apposita per dire guarda, in queste storie ci sono persone di colore come protagoniste è una forma di razzismo, l'ho detto, per me è così, è comunque una forma di razzismo mettere una razza su un piedistallo, esattamente come nel corso della storia purtroppo l'uomo bianco si è messo sul piedistallo, è una forma di razzismo, certo che noi. Se Disney Plus mettesse la categoria storie di bianchi, o mettesse la categoria storie di cinesi e così via, allora, cioè, o diciamo semplicemente storie di quel continente e dividiamo per continenti, per quanto riguarda la produzione fatta appositamente e pensata appositamente per rispecchiare una certa cultura di quei continenti lì, allora sì, quelle categorie puoi farmene, perché ovviamente c'è tutto un pensiero dietro riguardo la produzione, lo sviluppo e le stesse tematiche del film, eccetera. E invece quella categoria è proprio, guarda, il protagonista è una persona di colore, o i protagonisti, insomma, sono persone di colore, non questo film rispecchia la loro cultura, quello che volete, no. Cioè, quindi è soltanto, questo attore è di colore, quindi è un film che merita di stare in una categoria a parte per essere messa, diciamo, in risalto. Perché se siamo tutti uguali, perché devi dire oh guardate, qua c'è un protagonista con un uomo di colore? Perché secondo me sembra voler dare un contentino, lo capite questo? Per questo dico che secondo me è una forma di razzismo, perché non li stai trattando come noi. stai sottolineando una sorta di differenza che invece non deve più esistere, perché appunto non siamo razzisti, grazie a Dio, nel 2020, il più possibile tutti quanti nel mondo. Per fortuna non siamo più nella situazione di diversi decenni fa. Ok? Ok. Quindi, siamo tutti uguali? Siamo tutti uguali. Abbiate il coraggio di ammetterlo. Non che adesso fate i regali per scusarvi. Perché facendoli in questo modo, sottolineate che c'è qualcosa di sbagliato anche oggi. Cioè, mi ricordo questa aneddota, non mi ricordo quale fosse precisamente, preferisco appunto non andare nel dettaglio perché non voglio dire minchiate, però mi ricordo che c'è stato un attore che ha rifiutato un ruolo in un film, per quanto lui avesse fatto il provino per quel ruolo, perché ha capito che è stato preso per quel ruolo solo perché era un uomo di colore, quando altri candidati non di colore magari avevano fatto, appunto, secondo il suo punto di vista, una performance migliore. Quindi lui aveva sentito che c'era questa puzza qui e ha detto: no, guardate, cioè, se mi assumete perché sono stato veramente bravo nel provino e il migliore secondo voi, perfetto per questo ruolo, allora va bene, ma se mi assumete per il colore della mia pelle, no, va assunto qualcuno adatto a un ruolo perché è bravo. Quindi quando io punto quelle frecciatine tipo prima che hanno chiamato la sirenetta di colore, non è perché è di colore allora è un problema, mi raccomando, non fraintendetemi. Intendo, l'hanno davvero assunta perché è la migliore? Perché nel caso va benissimo, cioè basta che faccia bene la sirenetta. Anche se la cosa preoccupante per me non sono gli attori, ma sono gli sceneggiatori, che in qualsiasi colore della pelle abbiano, sarà meglio che scrivano bene un film. E appunto ho semplicemente paura quale sia la priorità effettiva. Se promuovere prodotti di qualità, fatti, sviluppati, recitati, scritti, diretti da persone di qualità, indipendentemente dal paese di provenienza, o se promuovere il più possibile rappresentare ogni parte del mondo all'interno di uno show. Ora, io lo so che questa cosa qui, questa categoria qui è stata aggiunta nel periodo nel quale c'è stata purtroppo la morte di George Floyd, ben famosa, ok? E quindi era il loro modo di dire la propria. Ciononostante, rimango dell'idea di tutto quello che ho detto prima, ok?
After Luca, I'm excited to announce two new films today, both releasing in 2022. In the spring of 22, we have an original film directed by another first-time feature director, Domi Shi, who won an Academy Award for her Pixar short film, Bao. Get ready for Turning Red. This is May, confident 13-year-old who's experiencing the excruciatingly awkwardness of being a teenager. Everything in her life is changing, her interests, her relationships, her body, balancing all this with family and crushes, and her devotion to the biggest boy band on the planet is no small feat. Oh, and one more little detail, whenever she gets too excited, which for a 13-year-old is like always, she uncontrollably poofs into a giant red panda. Kind of like the Incredible Hulk, but cuter. Turning Red is an original take on the great tradition of coming of age comedies, okay, albeit one with an emotional and a furry
Però,
twist.
Comunque Bao era un ottimo corto.
And coming in the summer of 2022 is a science fiction adventure film unlike anything we've done before.
Science fiction. What? Volete casarmi? Pixar science fiction.
At first glance, you might think this is a Toy Story film. Well, not so fast. See, back when we created the very first Toy Story, we designed Buzz Lightyear with the idea that he was a toy based on some
Star
really
Wars.
Cool character from an epic blockbuster film.
Basta vedere Toy Story 2.
Well, all
Star
these
Wars.
Years later, we decided it's time to make that film. Directed by Pixar vet Angus McLean, co-director of Finding Dory, Lightyear is the definitive origin story of the original Buzz Lightyear.
Ooh.
And it reveals how this young test pilot became the space ranger we all know him to be today. And we're excited to announce this new Buzz Lightyear will be voiced by none other than Chris Evans.
What?
You don't get much more traditional Pixar than Buzz.
Perché?
And we're excited to have Chris's help in bringing a new twist to this iconic character.
Cioè, nel
we
senso,
can't wait to take
off. Stai dicendo che il giocattolo
beyond, as Lightyear launches into theaters
che hanno prodotto basato su questo film.
So there you have
una voce diversa da quella del film, è il peggior giocattolo di sempre.
No,
ma quindi avete capito, non è uno spin-off di Buzz Lightyear, appunto. È un film di azione. E adesso arriva la Marvel. Non mi frega niente in realtà, però so che voi sì, quindi eccoci qua.
Good afternoon everyone. We at Marvel Studios are thrilled to have a home on Disney.
Sono genuinamente casato di Lightyear, perché in realtà non avrà nulla a che fare con Toy Story. E sarà Star Wars. Sarà Star Wars Pixar. Io ve lo dico, non ho mai visto Spider-Man Far From Home. Mi sono fermato con Endgame.
Making the MCU more immersive than ever. There's a lot of new content coming from Marvel Studios, so let's get started. WandaVision will be the very first Marvel Studios series on Disney Plus.
E questo mi interessa.
Wanda and Vision are two of our most powerful and complex heroes, and this series is a perfect expansion point for MCU storytelling.
Perché ha una struttura.
Launching on Disney Plus on January 15th, here's a look at the brand new trailer. For WandaVision.
Perché sembra avere quella struttura da episodi tipo Timmy Turner che va nei vari mondi dei cartoni. E io adoro queste cose. Abbiamo Sith Comedy. Quelle che ho visto anche io quando ero piccolo. Ho un'altra sitcomedy, però se mi fai soltanto diverse sitcomedy non ha senso. Devi cambiare genere. Eh no, mi state decadendo.
Wanda, what's up? Who are you? I don't know.
I think something's wrong here.
This is our home.
Then let's fight for it.
Più che altro non riesco a capire come ci sia materiale per un'intera serie. Però mi ispira.
Well, I think we handled that well.
Elizabeth Olsen is currently in London right now. She's shooting the film Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness.
Yes.
With director Sam Raimi,
esatto.
Star Benedict Cumberbatch and the rest of the cast, including Benedict Wong, Rachel McAdams and Chiwetel Ejiofor.
Sam Raimi che ritorna a dirigere un film.
New fan favorite character
Marvel.
From the comics, America Chavez, played by Sochi Gomez. This film hits theaters March 25th, 2022, and we're really pushing the boundaries of storytelling with this thrilling, scary, mind-bending adventure. Not only will Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness connect directly to the events of WandaVision, but it will also connect to the events of our new Spider-Man film coming to theaters December 2021.
Oh.
Moving to our next series for Disney Plus, which launches this coming March, The Falcon and the Winter Soldier features two recognizable superheroes last seen together in the final moments of Avengers Endgame.
E questo non mi ispira per niente.
Sam Wilson, aka The Falcon, is played by Anthony Mackie, and Bucky Barnes, the Winter Soldier, is played by Sebastian Stan. The Falcon and the Winter Soldier is a cinematic experience. It's a Marvel Studios movie played out over 6 episodes. And now here for the first time is an exclusive look at The Falcon and the Winter Soldier.
Che vedremo tutti. Ok. Dai. Incuriositemi, per favore. Già che sto pagando. Sta roba.
Complicated. Is upside down. People need something to get behind.
Finora abbiamo visto soltanto persone che annuiscono. Ok.
So no plan.
Great.
Faranno fanno vedere lui che usa lo scudo. Ah, questa è per dire, ehi, spendiamo i nostri soldi, io no? Non mi interessa, continuo a non interessarmi, che vi devo dire?
What's going on in that cyborg brain of yours?
You don't want to know.
Oh yeah, I can see it working. Gears turning. Oh, they're malfunctioning. They're on fire.
God, I hate you.
Oh, I know. This is the plan.
Now to another hero we last saw in Avengers Endgame, Black Widow will return to the big screen on May 7th, 2021. Of course, the film stars Scarlett Johansson as Natasha Romanoff. Fans have been patient, and I can't tell you just how ready we are for this Avenger to finally have her own standalone film. And speaking of fan favorite characters, Loki. The God of Mischief will step out of his brother's shadow and into his own series on Disney Plus in May of next year. The great Tom Hiddleston returns as Loki and is joined in the series by Owen Wilson, Gubernatha Raw, Sofia DiMartino, Mumni Mosaku, and Richard E.
Best
Grant.
Serie, best as serie. With our other shows Loki coming to Disney Plus, Wilson.
We want to try something a little different. Explore a new genre for us at Marvel Studios.
Uh-huh.
So we've put Loki in the center of his own crime thriller.
Sí.
If that sounds a little unusual or confusing, don't worry. Loki is just as confused. Here's the very first look. Ed Loki.
Yes, questo mi interessa. Ora che so che c'è anche Owen Wilson. Lo so che è basato su questa belinata della. Ma tanto vogliono fare il multiverso in Madness, no? Questo endgame che doveva dare. Doveva risolvere tutti i problemi. In realtà non ha fatto altro che causare i problemi che setteranno il resto. Io ripeto, non ho ancora visto Spider-Man Far From Home. Immagino che dicano qualcosa anche lì. Spinny, spinny, spinny guy, spinning, spinning, sull'unica cosa Marvel che mi interessa. Spinning, spinning, spinning guy, we don't know anything. Ok. Please, resist, resist. Ok, Star Wars 7. Lo sta andando anche a me a due frame, eh? Cioè state vedendo quello che state vedendo. C'è quello che sto vedendo. Hello there. Ti prego, vai a almeno qualche frame in più. Non chiedo tanto. Vabbè, dai, slideshow.
You're taking me somewhere to kill me.
No, I'm taking you someplace to talk.
Ma quello?
Where I lie, I don't like to talk.
But you do like to lie, which you just did.
Oh, wait, wait.
Because we both know you love to talk.
How long have you been here?
I don't know, it's hard to say. You know, time passes differently here in the TVA.
What does that mean?
You'll catch up.
What is going on? Eh?
Glorious.
Sono andati nella casa di sviluppo Marvel. What? What? What is going on?
I'm down. You'd better be ready.
Il mio pitch per la serie di Loki era lui che andava in un pianeta, diceva, salve, sono uno bravo, tranquilli, fa qualche casino che reazione a catena, distrugge il pianeta.
Come on. What did you expect?
E se ne va via da quel pianeta, episodio dopo va in un altro pianeta, salve, sono uno bravo, fa qualche casino e distrugge il pianeta.
Coming to Disney Plus next summer, What If flips the script on the MCU, taking famous events from the films and reimagining them in unexpected ways.
Questo era animato, no?
We've assembled a stellar voice cast with many MCU stars reprising their roles. Here's a look at What If.
Sì, due frame.
Space.
a Final Frontier. Dei Final Frontier. No, ok.
Reality.
Beh, è animato in cel shading.
It's a prism of endless possibility.
Well, that doesn't sound ominous at all.
Ah, quello era quel ma di colore.
I was promised an army.
Non sono un fan dello, del cel shading, ma sembra che qui le illuminazioni gestiscano molto meglio rispetto a tutti gli altri lavori di cel shading che ho visto.
What you doing out there all by yourself anyway?
Exploring the world.
Sounds fun. But why stop at one world when we can show you all of them?
E può essere divertente, se no.
I am the watcher.
Your guide through these vast new realities. Ah, ok.
Follow me and dare to face the unknown.
Io adoro Doctor Strange, quindi.
And ponder the question.
What if?
What if?
Give me the toy.
Vampire Doctor Strange versus Doctor Strange. I mean, basta, definitivo. Non best serie, ma fantastico.
We just production in Australia on our film Shang-Chi and the Legend of the Ten Rings, and we're so impressed the way Simu Liu has brought the character of Shang-Chi to life. Simu was surrounded on screen by a fantastic cast that includes Awkwafina, Tony Leung, and Michelle Yeoh. This film is among the very first in our Phase 4 and is set to release in theaters on July 9th, 2021.
Okay.
Launching on Disney Plus later next year is Miss Marvel. Miss Marvel is a Pakistani-American teen superhero. Earlier this year during shutdown, we held online auditions all around the world to find our Kamala Khan. And we found her in Iman Vellani. Iman will be surrounded by a phenomenal cast and creative team that will bring this story to life. So here's an early look at Miss Marvel.
Che noi non vedremo, e invece vedremo.
Miss Marvel is a new kind of superhero. But at the core of all of it, her story is so universal.
Miss Marvel is one of the newer characters in the Marvel comics. And when one comes in that grabs the world's imagination like this, the questions are, when are we going to bring Miss Marvel to the screen?
When Miss Marvel first came out, we had such an incredible reaction.
It was so incredibly popular because everybody could see themselves in her.
I never saw a young teenager of color, specifically a Pakistani, in a comic book. Are you kidding?
I promised you'd be cool.
I am cool.
The casting process was vast. When we discovered Iman, we knew that she was Kamala Khan.
It was a unanimous decision.
Yeah, I can't comprehend this right now.
And then, of course, we've got a really incredible team of directors. Bilal Fallah, Adel Al-Arabi, Mira Menon, and Sharmeen Obaid-Chinoy. And all of them are taking the material and elevating it.
So human. It's about a teenager figuring out who she is and about relationships. Family and friendship is at the heart of the MCU canon. That's what's so exciting about the story that we're bringing, is that we're going to introduce you to a new family that's also going to be part of the wider MCU.
Okay. Okay.
A fact about Miss Marvel is that her idol is Captain Marvel. And Captain Marvel 2 is currently in the works with director Nia DaCosta. And today I'm excited to announce that Miss Marvel, played by Iman, will be joining Brie Larson and co-starring in Captain Marvel 2, along with a grown-up Monica Rambeau, played by Tiana Paris, whom we will have already met in the upcoming WandaVision. So by now you should start getting a sense of the interconnectedness that infuses all of our story.
Quindi spoiler per il plot armor prima ancora di vedere il resto. Grazie amico.
With next year's Eternals, we're introducing a brand new ensemble of superheroes to the MCU, played by a spectacular cast.
What?
This is an epic story spanning thousands of years, and it's one of our most ambitious films yet. It's set for theatrical release
Allora, se tu mi dici un'altra volta ancora che è il tuo più film ambizioso di sempre, sei un cretino. Non puoi dire questa cosa dopo Endgame. Non puoi dirlo. Another well-known archer from Marvel Comics, Kate Bishop. And I'm very pleased to confirm that Kate will be played by the amazing Hailee Steinfeld. Rounding out that cast are Vera Farmiga, Fra Fee and newcomer Alacqua Cox playing Maya Lopez. Okay. The episodes are being directed by Rhys Thomas and the directing duo of Bert and Birdie. Debuting for the first time in the MCU, She-Hulk is coming to Disney Plus. It's a series about a woman trying to navigate the world and be taken seriously as a working professional, despite the fact that she's well over 6'7" and green. It's a very funny series being directed by Kat Coiro and Anu Valia. And I can officially confirm that She-Hulk / Jennifer Walters will be played by the talented and Emmy Award-winning Tatiana Maslany. I'm also pleased to reveal that the brilliant Tim Roth is returning as the Abomination, a character who first introduced to the MCU in 2008's The Incredible Hulk. And if that's not enough, I can confirm that the Hulk himself, Mark Ruffalo, will be appearing in the series as well. And since Jennifer Walters is a lawyer who specializes specifically in superhero-oriented legal cases, you never know what Marvel characters are going to pop up from episode to episode. Bringing a whole new different vibe to the MCU, Moon Knight is an action-adventure, Indiana Jones-type story coming to life as a Disney Plus series directed by Mohamed Diab. Come? The character Moon Knight is a complex vigilante who suffers from dissociative identity disorder.
Okay.
And these multiple identities that live inside him are very distinct characters in the series.
Ooh.
The backdrop of our story is incredible Egyptian iconography. Egyptology is something the world's always been fascinated by, and we're going to tap into it in a fun and bold way in Moon Knight. Now I want to talk about a couple of projects that we haven't announced yet. The first of which is Secret Invasion, coming to Disney Plus. Samuel L. Jackson is back as Nick Fury, and Ben Mendelsohn from Captain Marvel returns as the Skrull, Talos. Next to Civil War, Secret Invasion is arguably the biggest crossover comic event in the last 20 years, and we're bringing it to Disney Plus. It's about a sect of Skrulls who have infiltrated every level of life on Earth. Ironheart will be a series for Disney Plus about genius inventor Riri Williams, who has the most advanced suit of armor since Iron Man's. Dominique Thorne will play the title role. And as we like to do, both Secret Invasion and Ironheart will tie directly to MCU feature films. We're also well underway on a series for Disney Plus
per dire, dovete guardarlo, capito?
A classic Marvel story about Tony Stark's worst fear coming true. It's what happens when his tech falls into the wrong hands. And this series will star beloved member of the MCU, Don Cheadle, will be returning as Jim Rhodes, aka War Machine. One of the best things about expanding the MCU to Disney Plus is that our team at Marvel Studios is finally able to do some of the things we've always wanted to do, but didn't quite have the right outlet for.
Come.
Like produce our first ever live-action holiday special. In a reverent Guardians fashion, the Guardians of the Galaxy holiday special is going to be a lot of fun, especially since James Gunn is back to write and direct. In fact, we're going to shoot it during production of Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3. This special will drop the holiday prior to the next Guardians of the Galaxy film, which hits theaters in 2023. And speaking of Guardians, aptly titled I Am Groot, everyone's favorite little tree, Baby Groot, will star in a series of shorts on Disney Plus featuring several new and unusual characters. Before I go, I couldn't leave you without giving a few more updates on some of our most anticipated upcoming films. In January, we'll begin filming Thor, Love and Thunder with director Taika Waititi and Chris Hemsworth, Natalie Portman and Tessa Thompson returning. And I'm pleased to confirm that Academy Award winning actor Christian Bale is playing the villain, Gore the God Butcher. Thor, Love and Thunder releases in theaters on May 6, 2022.
Ooh.
As we announced at Comic-Con last year, we're moving ahead with Blade, starring Academy Award winner Mahershala Ali. The development and storylines are coming together, and we'll have announcements very, very soon.
Sentito, il web è gasatissimo.
Peyton Reed is hard at work with our Marvel Studios team on the third Ant-Man film, which will officially be called Ant-Man and the Wasp: Quantumania. Paul Rudd, Evangeline Lilly, Michael Douglas, and Michelle Pfeiffer are all returning. And Catherine Newton is joining the cast and playing
Comunque
Cassie
è un cast
Lang.
Fantastico quello di Ant-Man, posso dirlo.
And in the role of Kang the Conqueror, we have a great actor, Jonathan Majors.
Michelle Pfeiffer
I wanted to acknowledge the devastating loss of a dear friend and member of the Marvel Studios family. Chadwick Boseman was an immensely talented actor and an inspirational individual who affected all of our lives, professionally
and personally. His portrayal of T'Challa, the Black Panther, is iconic and transcends any iteration of the character in any other medium from Marvel's past. And it's for that reason that we will not recast the character. However, to honor the legacy that Chad helped us build through his portrayal of the King of Wakanda, we want to continue to explore the world of Wakanda and all of the rich and varied characters introduced in the first film. Writer-director Ryan Coogler is hard at work on the sequel now, and will bring the film to you in theaters July 8th, 2022. And finally, I'm happy to announce a film about one of the truly iconic Marvel families. In fact, Marvel's first family, Fantastic Four. We're working on a feature now, and it will be directed by the director of our recent Spider-Man films, John Watts.
Ma aspetta.
We've got a lot in store at Marvel Studios.
Fantastic Four is key fa parte to the MCU.
An expansion of the MCU. It will be home for both our feature films and our series for years and years to come. Since Marvel first joined Disney back in 2009, Bob Iger's been the biggest champion of the work that we do. None of this would have been possible without his support. So it is now my pleasure to turn things back over to Bob. Thank you.
Ovviamente mi spiace
what
per
an amazing presentation
Postman.
By Kevin and all of our creative executives. Truly astounding. As you just saw for yourselves, the same attributes that define our theatrical releases, the grand scale and scope, stunning artistry, and groundbreaking special effects are also apparent in many of the series we are producing. Of course, as remarkable as that presentation was, we obviously didn't have time to show you everything coming to Disney Plus, particularly a lot more original Disney-branded content. We launched the service last year with great ambition and high expectations, and we've exceeded them by every measure. There are thousands of episodes of television and hundreds of library titles and theatrical releases. It's truly spectacular.
Sì, però Toy Story 4 in Italia non è in 4K. Potete metterlo in 4K, per favore?
The content we're making is much more robust than we had initially anticipated, with an incredibly impressive number of great new episodic series, feature films, documentaries and specials. All coming to the service in the next few years. They'll also be arriving at a much quicker cadence. We've set a target of 100 plus new titles per year, and this includes Disney Animation, Disney Live Action, Pixar, Marvel, Star Wars, and National Geographic. And of course, we'll continue to add more to our rich library as well. It's been an unbelievable first year, and the response from audiences around the world has been extraordinary. We've clearly positioned ourselves as a leader in the direct-to-consumer space, and the fact is, we're only just getting started. This video truly captures why we're so excited about the future of Disney Plus.
The future.
Enjoy.
The future. Cioè, voi vi volete lasciare con la peggior parte di Big Hero 6? Sta canzone del manga? Niente, non è finito il video, ciao. Spero mi vogliate dire la vostra e addio.